بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today actually from NICU. If you will see the scenario first, this one is preterm, 29 weeks. Baby has been on CPAP, continuous positive airway pressure, for moderate respiratory distress and has been stable in 35% oxygen. So our team on call admit this patient, 29. And because he has moderate respiratory stress, he connected to nasal CPAP and oxygen requirement was 35%. Because if the severe retraction or severe RDS, this patient need intubation. Since the patient having moderate RDS and have a spontaneous breath, and patient putted in CPAP 35%, later on, what happened for this patient during the on-call time? He is active and has been noted to have quite marked intercostal retraction on occasion. The baby started to have marked intercostal retraction. He suddenly deteriorated with resistant transition and increase in oxygen requirement is reached to 95%. You see here, 95% oxygen requirement. It was 35 only. Initially, you admit the patient and was 35% oxygen. Now the baby start to have tachypnea, retraction, intercostal retraction, and oxygen requirement is increased to 95%. This is the most important, and this is the clue. If the oxygen requirement increase more than you set it, this put in your mind this patient having underlying pathology. Baby deteriorating in CPAP, you have to fix the head first. You have to fix the CPAP in the nasal, in the nose actually. Sometimes the CPAP it will be out, so you have to fix it. You have to check the bubbling if there is a patient on the bubble, nasal bubble CPAP. You have to check all of this, the technical issues. Might is leading to the baby is not comfortable in the baby's retraction and having oxygen requirement was increased. After you check your patient, clinical assessment, the breath sound and the symmetry of the chest, and you check thoroughly the baby clinically, and you put the head in the proper position, and the CPAP you fix it in the proper position, and the bubbling is there, and still the baby having retraction and intercostal retraction and the oxygen requirement increase, both in your mind, this patient having one of the most common complication of the CPAP is pneumothorax. Pneumothorax. So this is the message. Any baby on the nasal CPAP requiring oxygen more than you set it before, and start to be resistant retraction and desaturate and having retraction, you have to do X-ray to rule out what? Pneumothorax. Because the most common complication of the CPAP, pneumothorax and nasal damage. Pneumothorax and nasal damage. There is another complication. You can increase the intracranial tension and delta ventricular hemorrhage, can increase the intrathoracic pressure lead to pneumothorax and compromise the hemodynamics and decrease the venous return, decrease the cardiac output, and even can induce gut perforation. But the most common, it's pneumothorax and nasal septum damage. This is the common, and this is the message from this case. Actually, if the baby deteriorate on the CPAP, this is the X-ray. If you see here, this is, you have to describe the abnormality in the X-ray and how to manage this baby. First of all, you have to comment about this X-ray. This is pneumothorax, tension pneumothorax. Why tension pneumothorax? Is huge pneumothorax, and there is mediastinal shift and tracheal shift. Also, to mention this is tension pneumothorax, you have to look for the copula of diaphragm. If the copula of diaphragm is not preserved and the flat diaphragm, this is tension pneumothorax. It's not matter of mediastinal shift or tracheal shift, but they have to look for the copula of the diaphragm. The copula of the diaphragm is not preserved and flat, this is tension pneumothorax, with also the mediastinal shift and tracheal shift and the huge pneumothorax. So this is huge pneumothorax, tension pneumothorax. And if you see here, there is tracheal. You see the trachea here, the trachea. This is the trachea, and this is a bifurcation down here. This is a bifurcation here, and here the bifurcation. So this is the tracheal shift. There is tracheal shift, mediastinal and tracheal shift to right side, to right side. And this is oxygen probe. This is oxygen electrode or probe, transcutaneous oxygen probe. This is a probe. This is probe. Actually, this is probe. And unfortunately, you see this baby is not intubated. Surprising, this baby having pneumothorax and not intubated. You have, once you have tension pneumothorax, the first thing you have to intubate your patient, stabilize the patient, put the chest tube and drain the pneumothorax. So this is the tension pneumothorax. There is four finding in the x-ray. You have to describe it. First, large tension pneumothorax on the left side. The second issue, there is mediastinal shift to right side with tracheal deviation. The third one, transcutaneous oxygen electrode on the left upper chest. The fourth issue is actually surprising, the infant is not intubated. This is the description of the x-ray in this case. How to manage this patient? For sure, immediately drain the pneumothorax, and you have to intubate and ventilate baby is very likely to be needed in such cases. There is some issues you before maybe to request the x-ray. There is suspicion like trans illumination. You can do it. You can do needle aspiration before you insert the intercostal drain or to drain the pneumothorax. There is to do trans illuminations before the x-ray. It will give you clue also for diagnostic tools. But if tension pneumothorax, you have immediately intubate the patient and you have to insert pigtail or intercostal drain immediately, because is emergency. This is emergency. You have to act immediately. At the end, I would like to pray for our colleagues is going for exam next few days, and I would like to pray for our natal fellowship. The result it will come soon through these days. أسأل الله رب العرش العظيم أن ينجح زملائنا كل زملائنا اللي داخلين اختبارات إن شاء الله، وأشكركم وسلام عليكم.